We need to remind ourselves again, like, what helps us keep our email out of the spam folder or the promotion folder? How do we get people to open our emails and that sort of thing? So let's jump into that real quickly and talk about it. First of all, we need to set realistic expectations when it comes to email. So a lot of times people are super bummed when they see like a 17% open rate. And that isn't a great open rate, but right. But people, you're competing with people have gazillions of emails in their inbox and they don't open all their emails. So, you know, 17% isn't great, but you could still be really profitable with 17% open rate. When you first start your email list, you're going to see a big open rate because your email list is small. And actually, that's when you're going to see your higher open rates. And over time, as your email list gets bigger and kind of more diluted, your open rates are going to go a little bit down. But just have realistic expectations. We have some people in here who get 50 and 60% open rates. They're unicorns. It's rare. You know, Laura Belgray, I think she gets like between 30 and 40%. In my opinion, she sends the best emails on the face of the earth. You know, I mean, that's a really high open rate. So we want to set expectations. The other thing is don't forget to drive interaction in your emails. So you want to say somewhere in that email, asking them to reply back to a question that you ask. Ask a question. It could be very, very broad. Like, you know, what did you think of this? Let me know. Or what do you plan to do, you know, for your blankety blank? I'd love to hear from you. I read all my emails, like whatever. So that's one thing to be mindful of, because the email gods are looking and they want to see, like, are people, they see if people are responding to your emails. If people are responding to your emails, then you're going to get moved away from the promotion tab and in updates or in the primary folder, because they're going to assume that you're sending good emails because people are responding to them. Okay. So don't forget about that. The other thing is, you know, a very small percentage of people are going to do this if you ask them to, but the more creative and deliberate you are about it, the better off you are. And that is to make sure early on to educate your readers to add you to their contacts. So this is something that we use. It's a little gift that we did. We're happy to give it to you if you want to use it too. Nika can share that with you. It's just a gift that shows them exactly what to do. You could do a screenshot. You could do a little short video, but explaining to them like, hey, I'm going to send you, this is something to do really good. Like on your very first email of your nurture sequence to say, hey, you know, make sure and do this because I'm going to send you a ton of good emails and you don't want me to go to your spam folder. So do that. Create a little mystery in your subject line. Okay. This is really new. This is a skill. And there's a nuance to this. And sometimes you see it done really well. Sometimes you see it done really horribly and sort of in a manipulative kind of clickbait kind of way. One of my, this isn't really in regard to mystery, but one of my least favorite tactics that really rubs me the wrong way is when people put RE, like regarding, in a colon, but the thing is, that does work. It works on me all the time because it looks like it's part of a conversation that you've already started or had with a person. So you kind of look at it. I personally don't like that tactic, but it would sort of be like, you know what I'm talking about, create mystery. Like I did one not long ago that was like my most embarrassing moment. Well, what is your there's some mystery there. I want to know what Jen's most embarrassing moment was. So don't forget to create a little mystery. Write engaging short content. We all, you know, and that's not for like, you, maybe you want to write engaging long content. If it's a lot of people write really long emails and their audience gobbles it up. So that's not a rule, but generally speaking, people don't have a lot of time. Give them bullet points, get to the point, and don't make it a novel. Trim dead wheat. Wait. So this is scary. And I have a really good, you know, I have a podcast episode And I think we turned it into a blog post with Mel Farr, who talks in depth about cleaning your email list. And we might have a couple of more articles about it as well. But because there's different ways to do it, but the point is you need to do it. It's so hard to do because we work so hard for those leads. Some, you know, we paid money for them on Facebook, you know, there's a dollar amount attached to these email addresses. And then I'm asking you to go and to remove them, but I am, because it really improves the quality of your list. It increases your open rates, because think about it. If you're sending emails to people who haven't opened your emails in 90 days, and we're going to use that number, 90 days. So they haven't opened your emails in 90 days, and there's a large percentage or a large number of those on your email list. Well, your ESPs, your email service providers, see that, and it tells them that you don't have good emails. And they're going to be like, well, if she doesn't have good emails, we're not going to deliver these emails into the inbox of everybody else. We're going to put them in promotion, or we're going to put them in spam. And so it really does like make your list stink. It's like dead fish. Okay. So you want to be in the practice of doing that every 90 days or so. And there's a way to go about that. Don't delete them though. I mean, don't delete them entirely. Save that CSV file, export it as a CSV file, because you can use that list for retargeting. Now, if they unsubscribe, you can't do that. That's illegal. But if you just remove them yourself, put them in a CSV file, you can upload that into Facebook and then do and then wake them back up again, right? So send out some content directly targeted to this cold list and make them warm again. So keep that in mind. And then frequency. We all know this, and it's very hard for all of us, but we do need to frequently email regularly, you know, not just emailing for the sake of emailing, making sure that there's some value in there, but people will forget about you if you do not email them on a regular basis. And that's it.